So, hi, this is Jen of jenspringer.com and livegreen.solutions. And before we get started, I want to make sure you subscribe to this channel because you never know what I'm going to talk about. And today I'm going to talk about essential oils and cats. There is so much misinformation on the internet and in other places about using essential oils with our little friends right here, or big friends like him. Now, I will tell you, I've been using essential oils with cats for over 15 years, almost 16 years as of today, and I've never killed one. And I've had 4, 5, 6, 7 cats, and I've killed none of them, and I've done a lot of really cool stuff to support and maintain their wellness and how they feel and their vibrancy. And essential oils, and I got fur all over me too, up my nose and in my eyeballs. But cats are very easy, and the best part is you do not need a lot of essential oils for your cats. It's not like you're going to apply a lot of oils on your cats. And one of the rules of thumbs that I like to follow with cats, obviously less is more, and that's even the same for a human, because you figure for somebody that's 150 pounds, you might need 1 to 3 drops. Now with a cat, they're so small. I mean, you figure 1 to 3 drops for somebody 150 pounds, and then you're working with him who's 14 pounds, you need a lot less. So a couple of my favorite ways to use essential oils with cats is one, if there's a diffuser. This is a cold air diffuser that uses water. It's called an ultrasonic diffuser. So I put my oils in there and then it goes out into a vapor into the air. And my cats can come in and out of the room and they can, fur flying everywhere, they can enjoy the oils or not. You know, I kind of give them the choice. So I will never put oils in there that are really obtrusive or, you know, harsh, like cinnamon or oregano, not even for my own lungs, but for them. You know, for a rule of thumb with my own cats, what I like to do is use oils that are what I would use even on a child. Oils that are from flower sources or leaves or resins. So my favorites are like chamomile and lavender, frankincense, let's see, some of my other, ylang ylang, you know, things like that. Things that are very gentle and things that would not be too much for them because their metabolisms are different than ours. So to start dumping essential oils on your cat, you could overburden their system and make them sick. So again, the diffuser, you know, something like that I would put in, even if, you know, my cat is sneezing or something like seasonal is going on, just temporary, not sick. You know, I'll even put in some oils that support their respiratory system and even mine. And I'll be in my office working and they'll come in and out. And I figure if they don't want to be around it, they're going to leave. And it's that simple. And sometimes they'll actually go and sit next to the diffuser, which is really cool. To apply an essential oil on a cat, now, if you're new to this, I really don't suggest that you just start applying oils to your cats. Obviously, Mr. here, he's, you know, I have not drugged him. Today, he's just a big mush. You know, I will take a drop of essential oils. Now, I don't even really have something handy. Actually, I do. I've got a drop here. I'll be honest. You do not want to take your bottle of oil, open it up, and shove it in your cat's face like that, okay? That's not fair to them. It's not fair to a dog or even a horse. So when I've worked with cats, even in rescues, I will just either crack the oil and put it down on the ground and leave some variety of them to go and just smell what they want to smell and what is beneficial to them. Or I will even just take off the lid and just, you know, set out 2 or 3 and they will go choose the oil. I mean, literally they'll just go and I don't even know what they're choosing or why they're choosing it, but they will literally go over and they will gravitate to an oil and they'll just hang out there and take a few whiffs and alternate nostrils. And then when they're done, they just walk away. It's that cool versus taking an oil and making your cat smell it. You know, try this one. And forcing it to your animal is really not fair to them. And it's forceful and it can be traumatic. You know, I know people that have used oils on their animals and forced oils on their animals. And then when the animal sees them coming with a bottle of essential oil, the animal runs. You don't want to be that person. You know, if my cat, you know, if I wanted to apply an oil on my cat, I may choose 1 drop of essential oil. Like I said, like really gentle oils, like things that you would normally choose for a baby, like chamomile or lavender or blends that are made like that, you know, that are made for gentle situations, young people easily cross over to animals. And there are some essential oils that are actually blended specifically for animals. But say, you know, Mr. Mellow Man here wanted, you know, he was a little stinky or something, and I just wanted to freshen him up. I would just take one drop of essential oil, put it in my hand, really rub it in my hand so it's not drippy, and I might just pet him with it. And again, one of the most important things with cats is to make sure that you have pure essential oils. It is really important to have pure essential oils, because if you have essential oils that are adulterated with chemicals, you can make your cat really, really sick, and you could potentially cause some great damage to your cat. And I've known people who have really, let's just say, expedited the end of their animal's life because of using an oil that wasn't pure. So I don't ever want that to happen to you. So what I've done is I've put together a report for you. If you go up here to your right, on the right side of the screen, there is a button there that says the 12 questions to ask before you buy essential oils. I invite you to get that and read it. Read it and know what you need to ask so that you have pure oils for your pets. Essential oils are a great benefit and an addition to whatever types of animals that you have, but you want to make sure you have something that's safe for your companions. His tail's like, and not hurt your animals, you know. And I invite you to learn about using essential oils before you use them on your pets. You know, a cat is small, and you know, if you have maybe he'll come over here to your thing. This is his favorite toy in the entire planet. He's really killed it. It's a dragonfly type of thing. But you know, learn about essential oils so that you know what to do and how to use them. And I'm here to help you with that if that's something that you would like to know how to do. But again, make sure you get that 12 questions report and know how to use or know how to choose the essential oils that will be safe for you, your family, and your pets, and in your home. And then you go from there. Okay. So again, this is Jen. Make sure you subscribe, and we'll see you soon.